Hello, in this podcast, I will discuss the question of the study of culinary precisions. Culinary precisions are tips, proverbs, sayings, all technical indications in recipes that are not the definition. For example, if you make a pear jam, the definition includes using pears, water, sugar, and you cook. That's all. Now, if you give more information, for example, to add lemon juice to keep the jam of a white color, then it's a culinary precision. And the question is to study them quantitatively because science is only doing quantitative description. Now, the question arises, why are there culinary precisions? And one assumption is that such information was introduced by cooks when they had problems. For example, imagine that you miss or fail when you make a sauce mayonnaise. Obviously, you would ask yourself why. Is it the cold weather? Is it the hot temperature? Is it the moon? Is it the way you whipped your sauce? So you see, in front of a failure, human beings try to guess why in order to avoid them in the future. And my assumption in the past was that the more fragile the recipes are, the biggest number of culinary precision you have in culinary books. And in order to test this assumption, a quantitative parameter was needed to describe the fragility of a recipe, or which is the same, or the inverse, the robustness. Okay. In order to define such parameter, you have to consider that a recipe is a function of many variables. For example, when you make when you roast some meat, you have the roasting time, or duration, and the mass of the meat and the temperature of the oven. When you make a mayonnaise, you have the number of egg yolks, the quantity of vinegar you used, the quantity of oil. This is for the ingredients. And for the process now, you would have the quantity of oil that you add at each time when you whip. And of course, you would have also the energy of whipping. So you see, you have a function of some parameters that are describing the ingredients and the process. Now, in order to measure the robustness, you have to consider that it's like making the product is like walking at the summit of a mountain in a lane. And this lane can be very wide or very narrow. And of course, if it's narrow, the probability that you fall down the mountain is bigger. And this is the width of the lane that you have to consider. Now, this is not enough because imagine that you have a lane 10 meters wide, there is no problem for you to walk and to avoid falling. However, if you are a giant and your shoes are, let's say, 1 kilometer wide, you see that walking on the same lane is like walking on the edge of a razor blade. So we have to compare the width of the lane and the width of the shoe, in a way. And this is what I proposed some decades ago. And when you use this definition, of course it works perfectly, there are some technical details, but this is another story. Now you can come back to the question, do you have an invert proportion of precision and robustness? And what I did was to use culinary books of the past and to study some recipes, for example, pot-au-feu or boiled meat or mayonnaise or custard and so on. And indeed, if you look at the four red dots on the left, you see that the shape of the curve looks like the one of our assumption. But there is the problem of the last point on the right. For this particular recipe, the robustness is very, very big, and the number of precision is high. How is it possible? Indeed, for this particular recipe, it's boiled meat and stock as well. And we have to consider that in the past, this recipe was very, very important because when you grill meat, the meat is shrinking and you lose the juices. And in the past, when people did not have much meat, they had to be very careful about the process. And this is why roasting was less practiced than boiling. And the way this dish was prepared for a very, very long time attracted a lot of culinary precision for the turbidity of the liquid, for the temperature of heating, for the duration, and so on. And this is why here, because of historical reason, we have an exception. But let's keep the idea for the other recipe, the assumption holds. But now you see that we can investigate more and more recipes and find other exceptions because probably they will be very interesting to study.